Welcome back to the channel. As usual, the name is Director Vim, and today we're just taking it a bit quick. Yeah, we're taking it a bit faster. It's just a little filmmaking tutorials to make your filmmaking better. So if you are new on the channel, please subscribe to the channel, like this video as well. I really appreciate it if you do. So today we're talking about the Nifty 50. We're talking about the most underrated lens. We're talking about the lens that everybody is talking about. Without wasting my time, roll the intro. Director Femi. Director Femi. Director Femi. So welcome back to the channel. So today we're talking about this bad boy here. This bad boy right here, we're talking about the Nifty 50, we're talking about the Plastic Fantastic, we're talking about the 50mm STM. Okay, let me not just say STM, let's say 50mm, alright? I know most of you do have this lens here, and I can guarantee you, I can assure you, this is the most underrated lens in the filmmaking industry, okay? This lens right here has served me very well that I don't wanna lie, guys. If you guys do check the work that I do on Instagram, if you don't have me, just check me out on Instagram. The name is Director Vim. So if you guys don't know what I do filmmaking, photography, everything that has to do with filmmaking, I do that. That is something that I do personally. There are also other ones. So yes, guys, if you guys do know what I do, most of the time, in most of the project that I shoot, I use this bad boy right here, which is the Nifty 50. This thing right here does not leave my bag. Now, it's not the first Nifty 50 that I've owned. I've had a couple of them. The first one that I had was not the STM version. Okay, so now if you're wondering what the STM version is all about, it's basically the autofocus system. Alright, so the first one that came, it was fully plastic. What I mean is, this mount right here, you can see that this lens right here, it has a metal mount on it. You can see it's got some metal part. Okay, so the first one that came was fully plastic. There was no metal around it. That lens was something else. Well, maybe it's because of the price. So, and there isn't much price difference from the first one and this one. So if you're watching this and you're wondering whether to go with the STM or the normal one, personally, I would say go with the STM version because the STM is a bit, it's got a little bit of good quality in terms of the build. And the autofocus system is more silent, it's quiet than the previous one. So that is the whole difference between the STM, alright? The one without the STM, when it's focused on you, it's got this noise of me. But this one right here, you will not hear a single noise when it's focused on you. So that is the whole difference between the STM version and the normal one. So now, this lens, I don't know why a filmmaker or a photographer will not have this lens in his or her bag. Alright, so if you're a filmmaker, a photographer, whatever that you are, I highly recommend that you do get at least a 50mm in your bag. It doesn't matter whichever 50mm, because there are tens of 50mm. There is the Cine 50mm, there is even other third party brands that are making the 50mm starting from 1.8, there is 1.4, and then lastly I think there is 1.2. So that is the aperture number. So I think that the least, the minimum I've seen is the 1.8. I don't think there is F2. I haven't seen the F2. So this is the 1.8. So what it means is, this lens right here is very good in low light. You hardly get lenses for this price and also good in low light. Brand new price of this, I think it's roughly around 2,000 to 3,000 in South Africa, which means in dollars it should be probably maybe $150 or $100 maybe. It's very cheap. And for its quality and what it provides, guys, it's absolutely fantastic. So my main recommendation right here, guys, if you're a filmmaker, a photographer, just go for it. Go for it. But I'm not saying go for it and then ignore other lenses, because this lens right here is a 50mm. which means when you pair this on a crop sensor body, you are not getting the 50 millimeter. I'm sure you'll be getting roughly 80 or so. So when you pair this on a crop sensor body, what I mean by a crop sensor is the Canons, which I think the 80D, 70D, 650D, they are crop sensors. Alright, so the full frame sensors, that one is not a crop. So when you put this on the 5D, 6D, Sony A7S, those high-end cameras, you do get the actual 50mm. What it means is, when you put this on a 650D or something, what you're basically getting is going to be something like this. It's going to be fully cropped in. So when you put it on a full frame sensor, you get the wide angle view, which means you're getting the exact 50mm and not cropped in. But it doesn't matter whether it's a crop sensor or a full frame. Whatever camera that you got, this lens will still work absolutely fantastic. Most of the time, the photos, the videos, most of the things that I do use the 50mm. I'm not saying all the videos that I provide, I use the 50mm. But most of the scene, if I need those cinematic B-roll epic shots, I go with the 50mm. If I'm shooting a portrait, I still go with the 50mm. It's unless I'm doing something like a vlog or YouTube, something like this, whereby I need the wide type of that one, I don't go for the 50mm because I'm currently rocking on a crop sensor body, which is a 90D. So when I put this on there, it becomes more cropping, and then it becomes a problem because now they don't tend to see the whole depth of field. It's just a bit of me. So unless you got a full sensor, full sensor body like the 5Ds and so on, then you can put this and actually shoot vlogs and YouTube videos with it, which is way fantastic, guys. If you check here, I've shot this picture, I've shot that photo, I've shot a whole lot of photos, and trust me, 99% of my photos are shot on this. So yes, guys, that's it for today. I'll be coming with a whole lot. As I'm saying, if you are new on the channel, kindly subscribe. It really helps the channel, it really benefits the channel. As for now that I'm speaking, we are still less than 400 subscribers on the channel. We're trying our best to give all we can in terms of cinematography, tutorials, and entertainment. So if you are new on the channel, kindly hit on the subscribe button, like the video as well, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye for now.